Hey everybody out there, how's it going? My name is Tgizzle and welcome to this tutorial. In this video I'm going to show you how to add a bot to your Discord server. Now I was browsing around YouTube and I realized that there really aren't any videos out there showing you guys how to get a bot just into your Discord server. I've really only seen videos going over how to start developing a bot, which is useful, but not what most of you guys are looking for. You guys are looking for a video just to show you how to get a bot into your server, how to get it all set up. Now, don't worry. I'm here to tell you that the process is really simple. I'm going to show you here now. Now, keep in mind that this video assumes that you have everything already set up. You have your account. You have the client installed and you have a server ready to go. If not, this video is going to only cover the bot portion of this. But if you guys want more Discord content on the channel, just put comments down below with some suggestions and video ideas, and I will look over those. In the meantime, let's get started. Now, if you look in the description of this video, you'll see a link. Go ahead and open that one up. And that is carbonitex.net. Now, this link, this page, has a giant list of all the most popular and feature-rich Discord bots currently available to you guys. Now, I know there's other places you can find Discord bots probably being featured, like certain subreddits, but for our purposes, this site works pretty well. It has probably the most relevant bots to you guys anyways. Many of the other ones you'll find on other places are probably still early in development and probably aren't very fleshed out, so this is a great place to start. Now, what I suggest you guys is going over the list, looking at the servers, looking at the features, looking on how they work, how they use their commands, and finding the ones that work for you. And you can have more than one, just so you know. Now, keep in mind, before you go adding any bots to your server, make sure that you're signed in into your browser into the correct Discord account. And it needs to be in your browser itself, not just the client on your desktop. Now, before we go adding any bots, let me show you guys one that I recommend to most of you guys out there. Now, most of you guys out there are probably looking for a bot that kind of just does everything. Athex for me has been the bot that more or less does that. It has good moderation, it has some pretty fun commands, it has music. Basically, overall, it's kind of the bot that probably most of you are looking for. But don't go with this one just because I recommend it. There are other bots here that do a lot of different stuff, and it may not be the one for you. But it's the one I'll recommend to a majority of you guys out there. Now, once you're signed into the correct Discord account and you're all ready to go, just go ahead and click Add Bot to Server, and a window is going to pop up. Now you need to select a server. Now if you're signed into the correct account, you'll see the server that you want to add your bot to. For me, I only have one option, and it's my test server. Now below that, you're going to find the permissions that the bot wants in order to function on your server. Now Athex wants to be an administrator. Basically, that's so it can just do what it needs to do. It has permissions to do all the commands to work in your server. Now if you're not cool with that, there are other bots on this list that have lower permissions needed to function. But these bots aren't going to really mess with anything. Don't be afraid to give them administrator. That's for them to work properly. And I'm cool with that, so I'm going to hit authorize. It's all right. So it's authorized, and now it's good to go. I'm going to close out this window and minimize my browser. Now we're back here, and as you can see, Athex is now on the server. And let's go ahead and click on him. And he has his own new role. Let's go check that out in server settings. And then roles. All right, Athex. Now, Athex is an administrator. It's basically all it means. It's a role meant for him, and you can rename this if you want. But I'm going to show you guys a little tip right here. Go ahead and create a new role and call it whatever you guys want, but I'm going to call mine bots for right now. And this is especially useful if you're going to have more than one bot to organize them all together. I'm going to make the color, I guess, just green for right now and display role separately. I'm going to click on Athex, click on this little arrow right here, and give him a new role of bots. Even though it says it right here, it will move him into his own little category so that if you have other bots in the future, they'll all be under this list if you go and give them that role, of course. It's not automatic. And now one last little tip. Most of these bots, when you first get started, are a little overwhelming because you don't know how to make them work, but most of them have some kind of command to help, basically help you get started. For this bot, it's dash help. I'm using caps, H-E-L-P. All right, and there it goes. And now it has sent me a direct message with all the relevant information for this bot, all the commands it uses, links, and the Discord server. Now make sure to read over these commands because these are how you make the bot actually work. But here's the thing though, all these different bots will have different signs and signatures to actually activate them. This bot uses dash, some uses plus signs, some use exclamation points. So keep that in mind, but most of the time they'll have whatever that is in the actual playing section for the bot. And if not, you can go back to the page, look under usage and info, and find more stuff there. It's not that difficult. But that's basically it, guys. This is how you get started with a bot. And from here, you just play with the commands. You set up different sections of your server for the bot. If you don't want to have it all one jumbled mess, you can. You guys can do whatever you want. But these bots will make Discord more fun, and they will make potentially organizing stuff easier and adding new features that you didn't even know you could do in the first place. Now, if this video has helped you guys, please let me know. Leave a like on the video, or if it didn't help you at all, you can also leave a thumbs down. That is also useful information as well. And of course, if you have any feedback, comments, or concerns, the comments are a great place to get a hold of me, even though I don't check them all that often, but also my social media, like my Twitter, is a good place to reach out to me. But if you guys also have any ideas or suggestions for future videos, Discord-related or not, you can let me know. If I know about it and I feel comfortable making the video, I will. And I do know I don't upload here very often, but that's just because if I don't have any good ideas for these guides or tutorials, I can't really just make stuff up out of thin air. So if you guys like what I do here, you guys like my content, make sure to let me know. It helps me inspire to do more to help you guys, because the whole thing about this channel is to help you guys out there learn stuff, because sometimes things are a little overwhelming, but sometimes when someone can just sit and explain to you, it becomes all that simpler. All right, guys, I've been Tgizzle, and I'm signing off for today. Thank you guys for watching my video. I really do appreciate it.